Oklahoma lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's got it with room to run. Out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. 3 yards there on the play.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 28. Fires it out. Tackle at the 29. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
First and 10. Ball on the 37. And he's sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
That'll make it second and long.
They push him out at the 31. Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. Going deep, lays it out there. He got it. Touchdown, Nebraska. Wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. A six-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
So our score, 7-0. And they can forget about returning this one. Oklahoma's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two. And they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that he throws it.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
It's second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 20. Makes it out to about the 33.
Gain 13 on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
Easy.
He's into the open field. And he tackles him hard at the 41.
Each time you run an option, a big play is possible. This time they came up big on third down.
Hey, look, we're going to go Mike
15,
guys. Mike
15. Red 2. Panther 2. Blue 4.
Tackle made at the 44.
Penalty gain 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Dog, kill.
Orange 3.
Orange 3.
Got some open field. Quick throw, caught by the fullback.
With the catch. Call it a game of 4 yards. That makes us 8-3.
Tight.
6. Touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
Nebraska is up 7. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He's taken down at the 45.
Just a good showing on all three downs by the defense. That should fire him up.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Nebraska's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. On the ground with the tailback. Caught with room to work. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 16-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
That's a great tackle at the 8. It's second and long. Ball on their own 8.
Hey, look, we're gonna go Mike 15, guys. Mike 15, all right?
Watch the screen. Watch the screen.
Red 2. Blitz.
He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Hit immediately.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver. And he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
And they make the stop at about the 31.
That'll make it 7-7.
And he stopped behind the line. So we're looking at another third down here. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes at the 48. A good looking pass that time.
Well, here they do a nice job of getting the ball out to their speedy receiver. And he shows you that he not only can turn on the jets, but he's got pretty decent hands as well.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Nebraska. Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
Tight end right. Three down. Hey, look, we're going to go Mike 15, guys.
Got a man. Watch out here. Brought down at the 26.
Three down. That makes it first and 10.
Mike 15.
29.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Here comes the pressure. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long.
15's the mic. 15's the mic. I got 15.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's tackled at the 31-yard line. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Nebraska holds a four-point lead. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 27-yard line, second down.
Three down, three down.
40's Mike, 40's Mike.
Decent run here, right side.
That's a gain of five on the play. That makes it 33.
Watch the slant.
Check Mike 40. Check Mike 40.
Scrambling around. And he's tackled in the open field.
Gain of one on the play. That'll make it fourth and two.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Brought down at the 30-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's tackled right away.
First down.
Mike 15, guys. Mike 15, all right?
Hey, kill, kill, kill!
Five, flare, nine.
Makes the catch, and look out. Tackle at the 46-yard line.
Number 15 with the tackle at the 46-yard line.
Mike 15.
That'll make it second and four.
Kill, kill, kill!
He's into the open field. Makes it to the 34.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. First down.
15's the mic. 15's the mic. I got 15.
Hey, kill.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
What's the curl? What's the curl? What's the curl?
That brings him second and five.
Hey, Mike's. Mike.
Easy. Two.
Green. Nine.
Blue. 20.
Green. Nine.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. It's first and 10. Ball on the 24.
Roger, Roger. Hey, look, we're going to go Mike 15, guys. Mike 15, all right?
To the Roger, Roger.
Head two.
Looks for his running back, incomplete. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Caught out in the open. And he hits him hard at the 19-yard line. No, he dropped it, and that makes it fourth down.
Boy, great defense on that play. They were expecting the pass, and they defended it very well by getting a hand in there to break up the play.
Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. Oklahoma lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
Nebraska, up a point. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Finds his man and they take him down immediately.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. Third down.
He scrambles, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's at midfield. He gets hit out of bounds at the 34. So they get the first down on the quarterback scramble.
This guy just showed what makes him a great dual-threat quarterback.
Looking to capitalize on the big run. Now it's first and 10. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line. Good gain there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting him in the backfield.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. One's going deep to the end zone. Touchdown, Cornhuskers. Make it 2 TD catches now.
The quarterback knew exactly where to put the pass, and the receiver went out there and made the grab. Good communication there.
And he adds the extra point. A 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Sooners know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. Oklahoma's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From their own 41-yard line, second down. Tipped away.
Nice play by the big lineman, but the offensive line has to do a better job of giving this quarterback a lane to throw through.
They come out in a five wide set. Throws in a hurry. They can't connect. Incomplete. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
A great first half comes to a close. 14-6, Cornhusker.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Nice run up the middle. Strike to his receiver, no good.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
From their own 30-yard line, it's third down. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made around the 45-yard line.
Gain 15 on the play. First down.
I got 15.
Easy,
red,
two,
easy.
Yellow, three,
20,
yellow, three,
makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Red, two, orange, three, orange, three.
And they hit him in the backfield. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Nebraska is up by 8. Now he's scrambling. And he can't get away from the pressure.
That brings brings up second and 13.
So that sack sets him back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. He's scrambling, tries to get around the corner. They'll bring him down at the 21-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it 39.
They've got tight left, tight left.
Three down.
Mike 20. Go!
Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up fourth and one.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice play across the middle. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line.
Number one on the tackle at the 33-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Kill!
Black five!
Red seven!
He's on the run. He's taken down at the 25. So the quarterback picks up about 8 on the scramble.
That makes it second and 2.
Watch the team. Watch
easy, black 5. Easy. Black 5.
Blue 20.
Go.
On the ground, up the middle. And they make the stop at the 23-yard line. Intercepted. He might have a chance.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. Nebraska holds an 8-point advantage. Zips it to the tight end.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
At the 30, brought down at the 18.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive, attack, do some things to change it up, take some risks.
From the 18-yard line, it's first down. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it.
It might not be a lot of fun, but when you're a receiver, you've got to be able to take some hits and hang on to the football. It's just part of the game.
40's the mic. 40's the mic.
And down he goes at the 17.
That's a gain of one on the play. Third down.
From the 17-yard line. Third down.
Mike 20. Go!
And he's going to come up with a sack.
That's a loss of 8 yards. it fourth and long.
Nebraska can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. He gets it up, and he splits the uprights.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
17-6, Nebraska. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one.
Nebraska is the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
And he's sacked.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Easy.
He's tackled at the 33-yard line.
I'll give the defense all the credit here. Hey, that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down.
Dog four.
Knocked out of bounds around the 47-yard line. It's not over yet, folks. We head to the fourth quarter. Nebraska is in front by 11. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Quick throw. Tackle around the 41-yard line.
Call the game 12 yards. First down.
Check. Two. Dancing. Orange dancer. Three. Orange three. Go.
He fights forward to about the 39.
Game 2 yards. That'll make it 7-7.
Nice run there as they work the outside.
Call it a beam of 6 yards.
That'll
make it 3-1.
I got you, 88. I got you. Easy, red, two. Easy. Orange, three. 20. Orange, three.
And he's shoved out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Moves up in the pocket, and down he goes.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Quick throw. He scores. What a play. What a strike for the score.
And he did a nice job of looking off his defenders.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion.
Four down. 15's the mic. 15's the mic. I got 15.
He's got it. for two. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. A score here might effectively end this one. Nebraska is up by three. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 11.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on their own 24.
You can't block me. You can't block me. 40's the mic. Squeeze.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
That makes it 3-7.
Tries to buy some time. He keeps it, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line. And that is going to be enough for the first.
You and I talked about him earlier in the game. What impressed me there is he knew exactly where he needed to go to get the first down the whole time.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Scrimmage.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. He makes it to the 35-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. The Sooners are going to call their second timeout. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and cause him some problems.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 48. The Sooners coaching staff and the entire team knows that this is the guy that can win it for them.
The offense has to find a way to get the football into the hands of this running back, whether it's a simple toss sweep or maybe a ball out of the backfield where he can catch it in space. Any way that they can get the football to him to see if he can spring one to maybe get the field goal range, or who knows, maybe take it to the house.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle made at about the 41.
36, 36.
That'll bring up second and three.
The spike will stop the clock. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Nice run to the left there.
Easy, easy. Flare. And two. Check, check. Dancer, dancer. Go.
He steps out around the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on one play. That makes it second and 6.
Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 33-yard line. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here.
Kill, kill. Answer 2.
That makes it first and 10.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. He's in! Touchdown! And they
kicks the extra point. Oklahoma is ready to kick it away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. There's a fumble. The defense scoops it up. And he hits him hard at the 16. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game. And poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Show some moves and he's in. Oklahoma and staff, they've got to love the fact that they've got this kid in this situation week in and week out.
Yeah, I mean, they know that when the chips are on the table, they've got to find a way to be able to get him his touches. And this time he steps up in a big way for the touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. For Oklahoma, they've been coming after the quarterback all day long. This is turning into a day that the offensive line wants to forget. All the good plays from this defense has helped them into the lead. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
Mike 40, check Mike 40.
Flag 68.
He passes it, and that just might do it. Intercepted. He's at the 40. They'll bring him down at about the 31. Game, set, match. That interception's going to do it, partner. From the 31-yard line, first down, under a minute left. They'll get him for a loss.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
The Cornhuskers taking their first time out of the half. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Nebraska is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Nebraska's out of timeout.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 28-17. Oklahoma. As we take a look at the highlights, Kurt, how would you summarize the action in this one?
Oklahoma comes away with bragging rights this year, and I'm sure the fans and students will enjoy it just as much as the players. They were the better team today and added another great chapter to this rivalry.
Brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.